In this video, we are going to discuss the signs and symptoms indicative of Cauda Equina Syndrome. Get our very own assessment ebook and mobile app. Links are in the video description. Hi and welcome back to Physiotutors. Cauda Equina Syndrome, abbreviated as CES, refers to severe compression of the lumbar spinal nerves who form the cauda equina as they exit the spinal cord at the first lumbar vertebra. This compression can be caused by, but not limited to, disc prolapse, intraspinal tumor, epidural hematoma, lumbar anesthesia, or infection. Most of us who learned about CES in school as part of the screening process in low back pain probably recall to look for bladder or bowel dysfunction and saddle anesthesia as signs indicative of the condition that would require speedy referral to a neurosurgeon. Todd from 2017 conducted a review of the literature regarding guidelines for CES and argues that most guidelines list red flag signs and symptoms that manifest in late stages of the pathology and are mostly irreversible, resulting in lasting impairment. These signs and symptoms are falsely flagged as red flags and should be categorized as white flags, as they are no longer a warning sign, but a sign of surrender. We will revisit these at a later point of this video. From the literature, it becomes clear that CES can be divided into three stages, each with associated clinical signs and symptoms. The first is CESS, where the second S stands for suspected or subjective. Detecting CES in this stage has the best prognosis for the patient. Signs and symptoms in this first category include back pain with bilateral signs of radiculopathy, so loss of or diminished strength, feeling of touch and or reflexes, and or subjective sphincteric problems and or subjective perineal sensory changes with no objective evidence of CES. The second stage is abbreviated as CESI, where the I stands for incomplete. A patient in this category has objective evidence of CES, meaning reduced sphincter function of bowel and bladder, on top of the previously mentioned signs and symptoms, such as saddle anesthesia, which is loss of the sensation of the buttocks, perineum, and inner surfaces of the thighs. They may still retain voluntary control of micturition, but there can be disturbances in urgency, stream, hesitancy, as well as bladder or urethral sensation. If a patient is treated in this stage, they may restore bladder and bowel function to a level where catheterization is not required, but could have long-term impairment of sexual function if there was genital sensory loss prior to surgery. At last, there is CESR, where the R refers to retention. A patient in this last stage of CES has complete loss of sphincter function, including bladder and bowel dysfunction, with neurogenic retention of urine as the bladder is paralyzed and insensate. These patients usually have poor chances of recovery, even post-surgery. In the beginning of the video, I mentioned that guidelines commonly refer to white flag signs and symptoms instead of red flags to be looked for during screening. The problem is that a diagnosis based upon white flag features can be a diagnosis made too late. So let's look at a list of early definite red flags, possible red or white flags, and definite white flags. Definite red flags are bilateral radiculopathy and progressive neurological deficits in the legs. Possible red or white flags are impaired perineal sensation, impaired anal tone, and unspecified urinary disturbance. So essentially this means any new change in bladder function, but with preserved control. At last, definite white flags are urinary retention or incontinence, fecal incontinence, and perineal anesthesia. We have to be more suspicious of CES in order to possibly detect it at an early stage to provide the best prognosis for the patient. While signs and symptoms such as bowel and bladder dysfunction and saddle anesthesia have positive predictive value of CES, they form a diagnosis made too late and we should refer for an MRI as soon as we encounter a patient with bilateral signs of radiculopathy and progressively worsening of neurological deficits, who may also report new subjective changes in bladder function. OK, Okay, thanks a lot for watching this video on Cauda Equina Syndrome. We have a whole lot of tests for lumbar radicular syndrome, which you can check in the playlist on the left. The video description holds a ton of useful links, for example, to our ebook and mobile app. At this point, thanks to everyone who has purchased the book and the app already to support us in what we are doing. Before you go, make sure you are subscribed to this channel. It's completely free. And as always, this was Andreas for Physiotutors. I'll see you next time. Bye.